Good afternoon. Welcome to Sacred Hearts Parish. We welcome those present here at church and also those attending Mass via live stream at home. We gather today as a community of believers to celebrate God's great gifts to us, God's Word and the Eucharist. Today we celebrate the 21st Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider is Father John, assisted by Deacon Gill. And our Mass intention is for the parishioners of Sacred Hearts Parish. In today's Gospel, Jesus asks Simon Peter if he would like to follow others who are leaving. He replies, "Master, to whom shall we go?" How do these words impact us today? At times when our faith is difficult, can we, like Peter, recall that there is no other God who cares for or loves us the way our God, the only God, does? In a spirit of hospitality, I invite you to now stand and greet those around you. Let us now give praise and glory to our God.
Please join in singing number 567, "Praise the Lord, ye heavens." Number 567.
Praise the Lord, ye heavens, adore him. Praise him, angels in the high. Sun and moon rejoice before him. Praise him, all ye stars of light. Praise the Lord, for he has spoken. Worlds his mighty voice obeyed. Laws which never shall be broken, for their guidance he has made. Praise the Lord, for he is glorious. Never shall his promise fail. God has made his saints victorious. Sin and death shall not prevail. Praise the God of our salvation. Hosts on high his power proclaim. Heaven and earth and all creation, laud and magnify his name.
Good afternoon, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We gather here this Saturday afternoon, this beautiful day of summer, to praise God. We thank God for the gift of this day, but also the many blessings of our life. We also acknowledge our faults and our failings. Let's now pause briefly, review our life, call to mind our sins, and welcome God's mercy and God's peace this day.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let's now praise our God together. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of the world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Joshua. Joshua gathered together all the tribes of Israel at Shechem, summoning their elders, their leaders, their judges, and their officers. When they stood in ranks before God, Joshua addressed all the people. If it does not please you to serve the Lord, decide today whom you will serve, the gods your fathers served beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose country you are now dwelling. As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. But the people answered, far be it from us to forsake the Lord for the service of other gods. For it was the Lord our God who brought us and our fathers up out of the land of Egypt, out of a state of slavery. He performed these great miracles before our very eyes and protected us along our entire journey and among the peoples through whom we passed. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God. The word of the Lord.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. The Lord has eyes for the just and ears for their cry. The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from all their distress he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit he saves. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Many are the troubles of the just one, but out of them all the Lord delivers him. He watches over all his bones. Not one of them shall be broken. Taste and see the goodness of
a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, live in love. Christ loved us. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and handed himself over to her to sanctify her, cleansing her by the bath of water with the word, that he might present to himself the church in splendor, without spots or wrinkle or anything else, that she might be holy and without blemish. So also, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one hates his own flesh, but rather nourishes and cherishes it, even as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak in reference to Christ and the church. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to John. Many of Jesus' disciples who were listening said, "This saying is hard. Who can accept it?" Since Jesus knew that his disciples were murmuring about this, he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life, while the flesh is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are spirit and life, but there are some of you who do not believe." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the one who would betray him. And he said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer accompanied him. Jesus then said to the 12, "Do you also want to leave?" Simon Peter answered him, "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, good afternoon. I think it's interesting that today's Old Testament reading is a challenge. It's a challenge from Joshua. Are you going to continue to follow God? It was a chance for them to make a tangible recommitment to follow the Lord. And it's important because I think that our gospel readings for the last 4 weeks are doing something similar. It's a challenge for us to renew our belief and our commitment in the true presence of Jesus Christ in the bread and wine. So our readings from John started about 5 weeks ago, where there was the miracle of the loaves and fishes and feeding the 5,000, this tremendous miracle. And the next 4 weeks, those readings happen over the course of one day, where these people who were part of this miracle track down Jesus and they want to figure out, who is Jesus? What is Jesus? Who is this guy? And so over the last 4 weeks, there's been back and forth between Jesus and these people, and Jesus declaring that he is the bread of life. It's an intense back and forth, so intense that today's reading, the disciples say, this is hard. Who can listen to this? And if you look at some different translations, instead of the word hard, some translations say in Greek, this is offensive. Who can listen to this? And the words that Jesus uses are so, they are compelling, they are challenging. When he says, I am, he's referencing the Old Testament description of Yahweh saying, I am. He's declaring himself as God. And he says, eat my flesh and drink my blood. These are challenging, provocative statements from Jesus. So I want to stop for a second and think of this image. Have you ever given a bone to a dog? So my dog Murphy, just 2 weeks ago, we gave him this meaty bone. And Murphy was so focused on this bone, for over a half an hour, he worked at this bone, gnawing and gnawing. He wanted to get every bit of goodness out of that bone. Where when I went to take it from him, I said, okay, this is enough. And sometimes if you give him a bone and he's so obsessed and he's focused on it, that's all he's working on for a half hour. If I go to take it from him, he could sometimes give me a, like, what are you doing? I'm in the middle of this. And he would never bite me, but it's just a little subtle warning. Listen, I'm into this. And he's gnawing and gnawing and gnawing. When you look at it, he's transformed this bone. Everything has been taken off of it. And the reason I bring up that image is because in John's gospel, the Greek word that is used, that Jesus is using, is usually the word for eat is ethos. Ethos is the typical word for eat, eat my food. But in John's gospel, he's using the word trogo. And one way to translate that is to gnaw. It's a very coarse language. So if we look back at that and look at and think of Jesus saying, you need to gnaw on my flesh. You need to gnaw. And I bring that up just because when I look at Murphy focused on that bone, there's nothing subtle. There's nothing casual. He's embraced it. He's after it. This is something of value. And he wants to get every ounce, every bit of the deliciousness out of it. And I think that John, one of the reasons John uses that in his gospel, it's challenge us. We can't be casual. We can't be informal about our belief in the true presence of Jesus Christ in the body and blood in his bread and wine that we receive in the Eucharist. Jesus is inviting us to faith, and he invites us at Mass every Sunday to share in his keeping the promise. He invites us to believe, he invites us to faith, he invites us to latch on to him. But this is hard, and we should challenge it. We shouldn't just go along. This is immense. It's the central cornerstone of our faith, is receiving Jesus Christ, his flesh, his body and blood through the Eucharist. Jesus promises it to us. I will give you my flesh to eat. I will give you my blood to drink. So when in the sacrifice of the Mass, when does this Eucharistic miracle happen? And I would encourage you to open up page 18. Open up page 18 to look at the Eucharistic prayer. So when we take the bread out of the sacristy, it is just bread. We store it in cellophane containers. It's just bread. And then we transfer it to these golden patens and we bring them out at the ciborium. It's still just bread. And then during the offertory, it's brought up. Now the process is beginning to transform this from bread and wine into Jesus' body and blood. So on page 18, we look at the Eucharistic prayer. And I would encourage you, it's so easy to just tune out during the Eucharistic prayer because we're human beings. But I would encourage you to gnaw on this miracle that Jesus offers us. And one way to do that is to use our missals during the Eucharistic prayer. The one I love is Eucharistic prayer number 2. It's a common one. And if you look at that first paragraph, there's a special word for this opening. Every Eucharistic prayer has this. It's called the Epiclesis. And in this, he says, send down your spirit upon these gifts like the dewfall, so they may become the body and blood of Jesus Christ. And you see the priest making the cross. So that's the Epiclesis. And it's a Greek word meaning to invoke, to call down. There are some scholars, some theologians say, it's at that moment that the bread and wine become the body and blood of Jesus Christ. There's no unanimity. There's no unanimity on that. Some scholars propose that that's when the bread and wine become the body and blood. And then in the Eucharistic prayer, the priest, as the person of Christ, remembers the words of Christ at the Last Supper, take and eat, take and drink. And the clue for us is when the priest is holding up the bread or holding up the chalice, we ring the bells. And that's an old tradition from hundreds of years ago, where the crowds would be so great and it was long and it was in Latin and people weren't sure where they were in the Mass. When those bells rang, that meant Jesus Christ is here. He is truly present in this bread, which is his body. He is truly present in this cup of wine, which is his blood. So those bells are meant to wake us up and have us acknowledge and revere that Jesus Christ, the Eucharistic miracle, has happened. And then at the end of the Eucharistic miracle, that's where you have a role. The end of the Eucharistic miracle, where the priest and if the deacon is there, we hold up the body and blood of Jesus through him, with him, in him. The conclusion of that is called the great Amen. That's where you join in and you say, yes, I believe it is so. Amen. That's your role at the end of the Eucharistic prayer. Amen. Yes, Jesus Christ is truly present. So we approach the Eucharist not with the eyes of this world, but eyes of faith. It is a miracle that happens before our eyes, but it still looks like bread. It still looks like wine. But we believe in the true presence of Jesus Christ. Now, there are other Eucharistic miracles where the bread and wine, the body and blood, actually take on the appearance of flesh and blood. The Blessed Carlos Acutis, some of you have probably heard of him, young man, died at the age of 15, 2006. He died at the age of 15. But he had a passion for the Eucharist, and he had a passion for Eucharistic miracles. And using his technical skills, he was a bit of a whiz, he created a website that shows you different Eucharistic miracles around the world. So if you Google Eucharistic miracles, or you Google Blessed Carlos, you'll be able to find his website that chronicles Eucharistic miracles that have been approved by the church. And it's very interesting if you take a minute to look at this, because when they do scientific analysis on the flesh, it's the common denominator is they find that it's a heart muscle. And if they look at the blood, the wine that is now looking at the appearance of blood, it's type B blood. It's fascinating. And Blessed Carlos has now been cleared to sainthood. He'll be recognized as a saint within this next year. And some would say, what a tragedy for someone to die so young at the age of 15. What a victory. What a great victory for Carlos, who will be Saint Carlos in heaven, praising God, the true presence. And I thank God that we don't always deal with those Eucharistic miracles, the visible body and blood. I thank God that we have this chain of love. God the Father, who in the Old Testament was very, he said, no one can see my face and live. And God the Father sends his Son, Jesus Christ, who was charismatic. People followed him in droves. And Jesus, using bread and wine, gives us himself, gives us his body and blood. So we go from the terrible, frightening approach of God the Father to this approachable, lovable Jesus Christ. to Jesus Christ giving us his body and blood, which we can approach so simply, so plainly at Mass. The Eucharist is a great gift of love. We can't take it casually. Pray for God to give us that passion, like Blessed Carlos had, an awe, a reverence for Jesus Christ's true presence in the bread and wine as his body and blood. This is hard. It is hard. People turned and said, this is just too hard, and they left. But what does Peter say? Lord, you have the words of life. And it's a gift. We cannot just believe through our own will. Pray for God for the grace to grow in appreciation, to grow in reverence of his true presence in the Eucharist. Thank God that you're here to receive that gift. But today, over the last 4 weeks, we have this challenge. Don't take it for granted. Don't be casual. Do it with gusto. Do it with passion. Latch on to the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Lord, we believe. Lord, we believe. Help our unbelief in your precious presence in the body and blood.
Here we now stand as you and I profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Let's now offer our prayers to our Lord, acknowledging his awesome grace at work always in our lives.
That we, as members of the church, may share the saving message of Jesus through our compassionate outreach to others and by lives of faithful witness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may abound in generosity, mercy, and protection for all people of the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those whose lives are darkened by the shadow of sin or doubt may be drawn into the light of forgiveness and peace through the grace and mercy of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all members and households of this faith community may have the grace to choose this day to serve the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died in God's grace may taste and see the goodness of the Lord in eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parishioners of Sacred Hearts Parish, who we remember especially at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those prayers and concerns we hold silently in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Almighty God, listen to our prayers this day. Deepen our faith in the Eucharist, your holy presence in our life always. Help us to shine forth goodness and light in the world each day. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing number 616, I Have Loved You, number 616. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. Seek the face of the Lord and long for him. He will bring you his light and his peace. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. Seek the face of the Lord and long for him. He will bring you his joy and his hope. I have loved with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are
pray, my friends, that my sacrifice to you, little God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption, the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. My friends, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you lay the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image, set us over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we pray together.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, hosanna, hosanna. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and in his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to put out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat his bread and drink his cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together, Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the clergy, religious, and all your faith-filled people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, we have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we are always free from sin and safe from all distress of life, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. My friends, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace, God.
Peace, God. Amen.
During communion, please join in singing "Your Words Are Spirit and Life," number 606. Your Words Are Spirit and Life. Our spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. God's law is perfect, refreshing the soul, reviving the weary spirit. God's rule can be trusted, bringing us wisdom, bringing God's wisdom to birth. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death.
Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. God's precepts keep us, their purpose is right. They gladden the hearts of people. God's command is so clear, it brings us new vision, bringing God's light to our eyes. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. Living by God's truth is holy and sure. God's presence is everlasting. God's truth is eternal, bringing us justice, bringing God's justice to earth. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. God's word is precious, desired more than gold, worth more than we dare imagine. And sweeter than honey, this word will feed us, bringing fulfillment and joy. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting. And life, O Lord, richer than gold, stronger than death. Your words are spirit and life, O Lord, life everlasting.
We have only one announcement this afternoon. Please save the date for our annual parish and school picnic, Sunday, September the 15th, immediately after the 11:30 Mass. Have a blessed and safe weekend, everyone.
Thank you, Diane, for that parish news. And I'm already praying for some nice weather on the 15th. Hopefully we have some nice afternoon. We usually get a great crowd, so please mark your calendars. It's all free, no cost. Hot dogs, hamburgers, cotton candy, ice cream. A wonderful day for all the family and the kids. So please put that in your calendar. You come together again after a long, good summer, okay? Have a wonderful week. Stay well. God's blessing upon you. Let's now stand for our final prayers. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy and great effect and sustain us, so that in all things may please you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go forth glorifying God with your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a great week. Stay well.
Please join in singing number 382, the Celtic Alleluia, sending forth. Number 382. Disciples to bring all the world to the joy.